Hi, everybody, it's Don, and I hope you're having a fantastic day. Well, doesn't look like Carnival's done ordering cruise ships yet, at least for their fleet. We heard about the three ships they wanted to build as big as, like, the Oasis class, but that's not all they're building. Then we have Carnival Cruise Line, who is being forced to change itineraries for one of its ships because of civil unrest coming up in the place they wanted to visit. And then we have a new internet speed coming to Princess Medallion that actually has me a little bit excited. First off, let's talk about the Carnival Splendor having some upcoming cruises September and October that have now said, we have to change the itinerary. They're leaving from New Zealand and Australia, and they were supposed to be going for three stops in New Caledonia, but they still have civil unrest going on there, and there is demonstrations all the time and outbreaks of violence here and there. So Carnival Cruise Line is saying that they are just going to change the itinerary completely, and they won't be stopping in New Caledonia for that cruise ship. And I imagine many other cruise lines are also doing the exact same thing with any itineraries they have going into New Caledonia. It's kind of a shame. Very popular, very beautiful destination, you know, tropical area to visit, but they aren't going to take any chances with people and possibility of getting their cruise passengers into something that's very uncomfortable, so they're just going to skip the itinerary completely. Next, Carnival Corporation, we heard about the three mega ships, right? The three mega ships that are going to be 230,000 gross tons, approximately the same size as the Oasis class ships. Those are huge. And now it looks like, according to the sea trade out there in Italy, that they are looking at building 3 to 5 more ships besides that. Some of them going to IATA Cruise Lines and some of them going to Costa Cruise Lines, which could be a big benefit. Now, IATA kind of tends to do German passengers mostly, where Costa is mostly Italian with some other European countries as well. However, in recent times, Carnival has taken some of those ships from Costa. The Luminosa, for instance, brought over from Costa, and they're making it their Italian brand Carnival ship sort of thing. Well, that's left the fleet short in Costa a little bit, and with the cruising growing everywhere, including Europe and Italy, etc. So it looks like Costa is pretty excited to possibly get two new ship designs for their fleet as well as IATA Cruise Line. So if you're a fan of those cruise ships and cruise lines, you could be looking for some new ships coming in the near future, starting as early as 2029, which sounds like a long way out, but don't forget they also have order books for other ships already being built. So yeah, big news again coming from Carnival Cruise Line. Now we'd have to talk about Princess Cruise Line, which I am currently on right now, as they have just announced their new Medallion Max Wi-Fi service. Now, let's be clear, there's a difference between Wi-Fi and internet. And they used to call it, if you hear their basic advertisement, it would say fastest Wi-Fi at sea. What they mean by that is the connectivity on the ship, meaning the Medallion, you could order drinks, you could order food, you can check what's happening on the ship. That's pretty fast. That's not internet. That's not checking your email. That's not downloading something from TikTok or YouTube. That's not anything. That's not streaming services. That's the internet. Well, the Max is going to help increase that speed as well. A faster Wi-Fi service and internet service offered to those who have purchased the Princess Plus and the Princess Premier packages on their cruise. Seems like that's the way they're going. It'll be included with that package. Well, I'm pretty excited about that because there's two reasons. One, I have to work on a cruise ship, and many, 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 many people out there nowadays have to work on a cruise ship. Or even for somebody who wants to, say, relax in their cabin on a sea day. I have 4 sea days in a row. There's not much on the TV here. And if I'm in my cabin wanting to relax and just watch something, I can watch it on my computer and stream something. right now I'm having a lot of difficulty on this sailing with the current system. Well, with the Max, apparently I'll have prioritized in a higher amount of downloading and bandwidth that I can use, which is good for me and most people who want to stream. Now, the way they're testing this is also really unique. What they've done is they're getting together a bunch of gamers and they're bringing them on the Enchanted Princess. I believe it's a Minecraft type system that they're going to be playing, where they're going to be competing to find their way out of this labyrinth that they've created for them to work. Like it's a contest. But they're bringing a certain amount of them on the Enchanted Princess, and then they're playing a bunch of other people who are at home on standard high-speed internet from your home. And they'll be competing each other. And they're going to show you, look, the speeds that we're going to be getting are pretty much what they're getting on land. And that's really exciting because, for instance, if you work from home and you're trying to open an email and you have bad internet, you know how frustrating it can be if you're trying to reach somebody for any reason. Myself, working on a cruise ship, doing these videos, for instance, here today, when I'm done editing this video, it will take me between 7 to 10 hours just to upload this to the internet. I also have work programs, trying to log into my, you know, make payments for people for their cruises, trying to access my editing software even, or anything like that, streaming movies, Disney Plus, anything like that. It's very, very slow to do because streaming, like downloading, is usually much faster than uploading to a system. So I'm very excited because games use both. In order to play a game online, you have to have a relatively fast connection both directions. So I'm looking forward to this new service. It comes online August 31st of this year, and I have my finger crossed that it's all it says it is. I will be on the Sun Princess next month doing a transatlantic across the ocean. And so if there's ever a time that that service is going to be slow, it'll be on that cruise. That'll be one of those destinations that'll be bad internet because you're in the middle of the ocean and the weather, etc. So I'll be able to test that system out for myself. I'll let you know how it is. But if anyone needs to work, or anyone needs to be in contact with people, or just likes to stream stuff on the computer while they're relaxing on a sea day or something, this is exciting news if you're going on a Princess cruise in the future. Well, I hope you appreciate this video. Let me know, do you care about internet at all? More and more people do, as more and more people need that connectivity and need to be able to reach people. And also, if you use your phone and it has Wi-Fi connectivity and you can send messages and text messages while on the internet, that's a big good service, right? That the faster internet you have, the better that connection is as well. I'm kind of excited about it. I'm also curious to see what kind of ships they're going to build for Costa and Aida. Are they going to be a new design, or are they just going to rebuild one of their newest one with some changes? Well, I hope you appreciate this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Want to see more tips, more tricks, more travel vlogs from around the world? Hit that subscribe button. Till next time, have yourself a safe and a great vacation.